Can everyone have a seat, please, so we can start our session? Shall we begin? Welcome to our third session of the day. Understanding the complexities of the data universe and its components has never been as critical as it is today, as we navigate the era of big data. Is there such a thing as too much data? Can we starve in its abundance? Have we as individuals become more vulnerable than ever before? And what is the role of ICT companies in all of this? But most importantly, what is their role in ensuring digital sustainability? This next session with experts from this in this area will hopefully answer some of these questions. Please welcome Mr. Ashraf, Director of Cloud Park Autonomous.
Hello, good afternoon. So I'm here today to talk to you about the data universe and how it relates to our vision to the city of NEOM to be a cognitive city. But first, let me start sharing with you what NEOM is.
Since the beginning, we've changed things. It's in our genes. It's what makes us human. Now, we have a chance to change everything. Let's change water so it flows forever, energy so it powers your life sustainably, and mobility so cities become playgrounds. Let's change the way we feed the world, designed to live with nature, and create factories that make the future better. Let's change learning so it's lifelong. Technology so it predicts our needs. And let's help prevent more illness than we need to cure. Let's change the way we think about money, how we explore the world around us, and how experiences come to life. This is where we can change it all. NEOM, made to change.
So as I said, NEOM is being built to be a cognitive city from the get-go. And to explain what cognitive means, I'll just explain to you the journey of moving from smart city into cognitive city. Technology is evolving quite fast. So in a smart city, the platforms use less than 10% of the data provided in a city. While in a cognitive city, the platforms will use more than 90% of the data. In a smart city, the platforms are more about machine and machine-centric and IoT-centric, while in a cognitive city, it's more of human-centric. Therefore, we see that smart cities to be reactive, while cognitive cities will be proactive. In a cognitive city, it's not just the normal data that we use, but also we span all the social media platforms to collect more data about what's happening and the interactions of people so that the AI engines in the background can kick in and start understanding and developing new scenarios and new insights. So a cognitive city actually thinks and predicts. Now, in a cognitive city, you expect to have exceptional service for the citizens living in that city. One example is in the area of healthcare. You expect to get exceptional healthcare systems supporting you, and that's healthcare system will not only look at your health record, but will also be tracking your vital signs across a long period of time, looking at the environments where you are entering, temperatures, elevations, humidity, and so on, and then predict if you are walking into a hazardous situation, and it will warn you. So cognitive cities provide more scenarios and more predictions for the people. Another example is what happens in a tourist scenario. So we all, when we travel to a city for vacation, we do some planning and we try to find out what we like and where we want to go. So, and at least for me, I know that sometimes we go on a vacation and then we find out that there were certain attractions or activities that I would have liked to know about, but I didn't know about. And it's usually too late to go and book it. In a cognitive city scenario, the city will have been tracking your behaviors, your sentiments, and what you like and what you dislike, what you've been liking on the net, and what, and then it will start searching all the activities in the city you're visiting, and also even special events that are happening during your travel, and help you do the planning. It will also help with the arrangements of the transport from one place to another based on the environment, on the transportations, on the traffic, and so on. So it will help you enjoy, get the best out of this visit. Now, to do all of this and to build such a cognitive city, NEOM has established a special company for technology, and the company is called Tonomus. So what is Tonomus? Tonomus is a cognitive technology company aiming to build the cognitive platforms of NEOM by delivering the enabling infrastructure and fully autonomous turnkey solutions. And we do that by investing in cutting-edge AI technologies, robotics, and human-machine interface technologies. At NEOM, we have three main objectives. Number one is to build the cognitive platform. And number two is to ignite the development of hyper-disruptive solutions that will allow us to provide all of these situations and use the AI and use all these data for the cognitive city. And this is something that we're doing now in parallel of building the city. So it is happening as we speak, a lot of solutions being built and tested and tried. So when time comes, all these solutions are ready. Our third objective is to attract the top talent around the world, those people who can dream and execute, so we can build something that has not been done before. So these are our three objectives. Now, cognition means data, a lot of data. And data means trust. So to get data, we have to have trust. Many of us, when we download applications and portals and so on, we click sometimes yes or sometimes no to data privacy policies, and many of us will not know what happens to the data, how it is used. In the scenario of what we're building a specialized consent management platform that has easy user interface that will put the control of the data in the hand of the owner of the data, whereby there is a simple user interface, and you look at all the applications that are available in the city, and you opt in and out to use the data in any of the city. And you can even do it on a short period of time. So you're visiting a doctor today, you opt to authorize him to use your data, you go out, you opt to deauthorize him to use it. You can do all of that. So this is user-friendly, easy to use, and this, we hope that it develops trust. And with this trust, we'll be able to get all this data that we need. It's not just the data of the people, but the data on their activities, the data of their interactions, so we can really develop insights. So let's take data and platform to the next step. We decided to build data centers that are very sophisticated, best in class, all green, and certified with the highest level of certification in order to be able to put these data, house it securely, either physical and data, and from technology as well. So these data centers are green. NEOM is currently developing all kinds of green technologies from solar, wind, and hydrogen. And over the next few years, we're going to have the entire NEOM powered up by green energy. So our data centers will be powered by full green energy in the next years to come. It is also built to the highest level of sustainability, and it's also efficient. It has very high efficiencies in terms of power utilization and everything, and it's all done reliable. Now, what we envision to do is not just a data center or data for NEOM, but we are now, our vision is to build an international data hub. And our location, if you look at our location at NEOM, being between the east center of data in Singapore and the west in Dublin, we're very well positioned to cover our region that we have defined for ourselves, being Middle East, North Africa, and East Europe. So this is the region that we are targeting to serve from this international data powerhouse, and we intend to build 250 megawatt worth of data centers, which is equivalent to 15 data centers between now and 2030. And the reason we came up with this vision is because when we look at the region, we found that it is underpenetrated with regards to data centers compared to other parts of the world. And we see that the growth of demand for cloud services is going much faster than the available data centers. So we have decided to take this challenge and start building our data centers to host all of these applications for NEOM and the region and the wider region. So we're currently starting to build tier 3 plus data centers at NEOM, spaced out to provide proper resiliency and redundancies between them to attract the hyperscalers like Oracle, Microsoft, Google, and so on. And we're going to start our first data center, we'll start delivering services early next year. And to complete the story, we also focused on connectivity. So we're landing two subsea cables at NEOM, coming from Europe and going to the east. So we're able to provide high-speed bandwidth, east and west, with very low latency, and that is a great motivation for everybody to port their data and platforms at NEOM. We expect the first wet segment to be available in Q3 next year, and the other remaining project will complete in Q3 2024. We've established a special company specialized in data center. It's called Zero Point DC, and it's tasked to build the first three data centers at NEOM, which is in progress, and it will see the light in the first half of next year. So I hope that I've explained to you how we're managing this data and what we're doing at NEOM, and thank you very much.